Hey guys, my name is That Quiet Kid, and today we are going to do NPTEL Ethical Hacking Week 1 assignment. So the first question is, which of the following statement is are true with respect to penetration testing of a network? In a white box model, the tester has complete information about the network. In a black box, the tester has complete information. It is wrong. In black box model, the tester doesn't have any information. In a gray box testing, it has partial information. It is true. And a red box model is not present. Which of the following statement is not there? Which of the following statement is are true for packet switching? A point-to-point connection, a communication link may be shared by more than one end-to-end connections. It is true. A point-to-point connection is dedicated. It is not dedicated when it comes to packet switching network. The packet transfer delay between a pair of nodes is more or less constant during the entire period. Yes, it is, because it holds the packet and then sends it, forwards the packet. And next we have, the packet transfer delay between a pair of nodes may depend on the prevailing network traffic. So this can be true. So the third question is, packet of size is 5000 bytes is sent over a 100 kilobits per second point to point link whose propagation delay is 5 milliseconds. The packet will reach the destination after how many milliseconds? The answer is 405, and I can explain you how. Let's see, the size of the packet is 5000 bytes and the speed is in bits. So we know that one byte has 8 bits. So when you multiply 5000 by 8, the answer is 40,000. After we have 100 kilo bits per second, but we have kilo here. So we know that 1 kilo equals to 1000. So that when we multiply 100 by 1000 and divide it by 40,000, which was obtained by 5000 multiplied by 8, we get 0.4. But this 0.4 comes in seconds. But you can see that there propagation delay is 5 milliseconds. So we know that 1 second equals to 1000 milliseconds. So we will have to multiply 0.4 into 1000, which will be 400, and plus 5. So the answer is 405 milliseconds. Which of the following OSI layer is responsible for node-to-node routing of packets? So I have a bit of doubt in this, because I have found the answer to be data link layer a lot of the places, but to be very honest, in the PDF I read it that node-to-node routing of packets is done by network layer. So I will be clicking on network layer, but I think it can be data link layer. What is the purpose of the port number in the TCP/IP network? So the port number is used to identify the process which is asking for data. So it is none of these. Which of the following statement is are true for the TCP protocol? It provides collection oriented. Yes, it is true. Reliable packet transfer service, and it provides connectionless. Connectionless is by UDP. Connection oriented is by TCP. So this one is correct. After that, we have a packet from a source to destination follow the same path. It routes the packet from. I am also in doubt about this one, but I'll think it should be all the packets from a source to the destination follow the same path. Does it follow the same path? And let's answer the seventh question first. Which of the following are valid port numbers in TCP/IP? 10,000 is correct. 50,000 is correct, because the total number of ports is 65,535. So after that, it goes over this 1,000 goes over that number. So this can't be a valid port number. If the IP header is 256 bits long, what will be the value of HLN field? So the value of HNL field is its header length, and if it was in bytes, then we will divide it by 4, but this is in bits, so we will divide it by 32. And when we divide 256 by 32, the answer is 8. So we will click none of these. The maximum size of data that can be accommodated in an IP datagram is how many bytes? It's 65,535 bytes. Which of the following statements is true for a small number of packets? Datagram is faster than virtual networks. It is true for a large number of packets. Datagram it's not correct. It is correct for smaller number of packets. In a datagram, a dedicated communication path is established between two. I don't think so. It's, I guess, in virtual circuits. In datagram, it is not required to establish a connection between two ends. So this A and D is the last answer. And coming up to this, it is correct. All the packets from a source to destination follow the same path when it comes to TCP model, and it routes the packet from one node to next. So that completes our assignment 1.